arms here are so weak.
Exercises look easy, but what I'm not showing is my arms feel like they're gonna fall off right now.
All right guys, so I just finished day two of the Chloe workout. This one was pretty intense. Hey y'all, welcome back to my channel. In today's video, I'm gonna be sharing with you my results from week one of the 2020 Chloe Ting Summer Shred Challenge, as well as just my overall thoughts on the program, the pros, the cons, just everything, how I felt, just to give you guys a full, raw, honest review of what I think of the program so far. Before I started, I went ahead and measured myself. I just went ahead and measured my hips, my waist, and like my little area where there's been a little bit of a pudge since quarantine. And the reason I did that is just because I don't personally own a scale. My goal is to really tone and to firm up and lose some inches around my waist. So that is why I took measurements, because my goal is to lose a few inches or maybe even just a couple of inches on my waist, just so my clothes fit better again, since they were getting a little snug from all of those quarantine snacks. So before we get into kind of my results and how I felt after each day, I just wanted to go and give a high level overview of what I feel like are the pros and cons of this workout routine. So one of the biggest pros for me was that with all of her exercises, she gave out a low impact modified version. And so I will say, I think I am just in average shape, maybe trending towards like the below average. So while I am naturally fairly thin, I don't work out regularly and my stamina and endurance is very low and my strength is also very low. So I did appreciate that she had low impact workouts for almost a majority of her exercises, and I probably did about half of the exercises in the low impact or modified version. I did feel myself getting stronger though as the week progressed, but I will say I think that is a great option. It makes this workout really great for both experienced individuals as well as beginners. The other thing that I thought was really awesome was that before we started the next exercise, she had a little block down in the corner of the screen so you can kind of see, okay, this is what I'm doing, this is what's coming up next, so you can kind of mentally get ready for it, if that makes sense. So I always liked knowing what was coming up, so I found that to be a really positive in the workout videos as well. The third thing that I found extremely helpful was she has like a little timer bar up at the top of her workouts, which I thought was awesome. She counts down whether it be a minute, 30 seconds, 45 seconds. So you always look like you're so close to the finish line, which I think is great for the way I think mentally about working out. It's like, okay, I'm done with that exercise, or only 10 more seconds and I'm done with that exercise and I'm moving on. So that was really nice. And alongside it was also a little bar that showed how far along you were progressing towards completing that entire workout. On the flip side, there was a couple of cons to just her overall workouts in general, in my opinion. The first thing was that not all the videos needed for the Summer Shred Challenge were on the Summer Shred playlist, so I was having to go through and search for them a few times on my TV. So I guess I got a little bit extra of a break, but I would have liked them all to be in one spot, so that was a little bit annoying at times. The second thing that I wasn't a huge fan of was the music. The music was very low and mellow, and while maybe many found it relaxing, I didn't. So I actually turned down the volume and I put on some 90s pop music on my Alexa app and let that blast while I was working out. I kind of matched the tone of the workout a little bit more with all the bouncing and hopping around. So that really motivated me a lot more while I was doing the exercises. So that is one thing that I did not like that much. And finally, the last thing that I wasn't a huge fan of was the fact that when you break down her workouts into each day, there is a couple of, I guess, required workouts, and then there is some optional workouts. But when you're looking at the total time, it looks like it only takes into account the two mandatory workouts for the day and not all the optional stuff.
So if you add in a lot of those optional categories, there's usually like a warm up, a cool down, and maybe an extra video or two. That adds another 30 minutes or so to your total workout. So if you do everything, including the optional stuff, you're looking pretty much about at an hour of working out. So those are my pros and cons of the overall program. And then we'll kind of get into my results. Week one included 2 rest days, which I took. And so day one, I did that. I was excited. I was pumped. This was part of a group challenge. I was so excited to get out there and do it. And let me tell you, that workout freaking killed me. I was exhausted. I did so many more modifications than I ever anticipated that I would be doing. I really felt that I had not been working out in a while. So then on to day two, I woke up extremely, extremely sore. And it was kind of a little demotivating for me, honestly, to want to even attempt day two with how sore I was feeling. But being part of that group challenge kind of pushed me into like, okay, Kathy, you've committed. So let's go ahead and do day two's exercises. Day two was really ab heavy and my abs were feeling really, really good after that. They did not feel like terrible. They actually felt like they were very well worked out. So I actually really enjoyed her ab workouts.
All right, guys, so I just finished day two of the Chloe workout. This one was pretty intense. I did the warm up, the ab exercises, and then it's the waist and round butt moves or routine. This last one was a 16 minute workout plus the 10 minute ab workout and then the warm up. So this is about 40-45 minutes altogether with the rest breaks broken down. So it was a pretty intense workout, pretty time consuming, but I feel good and I'm hoping I see results. I was super sore this morning. I imagine I will be sore. I've been doing some of the modified workouts, but that's my recap of day two. I have been trying to eat healthier and drink more water. So I'm hoping it's paying off in losing some inches.
Now, when we get to day three, let me tell you, that was a killer because my arms here are so weak and day three was all arms and it was intense. I legit felt like my arms were going to fall off. I just felt like, oh my God, they felt like they were about to fall off my body. And day four was just a rest day. I did not do anything that day. I did not overachieve and do any sort of other workouts. I just went about my daily routine. I did walk a little bit while the kids were bike riding, but definitely nothing excessive, nothing I would consider working out. And then we hopped into day five. So after a rest day, I felt completely unmotivated to keep going. So I did day five and day six. I did the full workouts, everything that was required. I did not do the optional pieces, but I think the 20 to 30 minutes that I worked out for the required parts of those workouts were very sufficient. I was still very sore. And I will say I could definitely feel myself getting stronger. So I would say from doing about 50% of the modified workouts, I probably moved down to like 30 to 40% of the modified workouts. I'm not saying that there was this magical change where I'm not doing anything modified anymore, but I definitely felt myself getting stronger, which I really enjoyed. That pumped me up and I was like, okay, this is working. It is doing something. So that itself was a great motivation for me, just feeling like I was getting stronger every single day. Here we are on day seven. So today is day seven and it's a rest day. So I'm recording this video. At the end of week one, it looks like I lost about an inch off my waist. So I'm not sure if that's water weight, only time will tell, but I will say I feel much stronger. I feel healthier and I feel motivated to complete the rest of this challenge, which is an additional 3 weeks. Now, I'm not gonna do a video for each and every single week, but I will post a video of my results at the end of week four. Alrighty, guys, so that is my feedback and results from week one of the Chloe Ting 2020 Summer Shred. It is a 30-day program. These are my results after week one. I am excited to complete the entire program. And it definitely has helped that I have a group of friends that is motivating me along the way. The workouts are good. I definitely recommend it, but they are not easy. So definitely don't think that this is a quick fix. You do have to put in the time, the effort, and the work to go ahead and get some results. I'm excited to see what the next 3 weeks has to bring. Catch you guys in the next one. Bye, guys.